Please rise for pledge allegiance. Pledge allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing. Those moments of silence for the sick, handicapped, departed, and especially the military personnel of this community on day of Veterans Day. Thank you. We'll talk.
President Mike Coleman?
Here.
Vice President Bruce Cavendish?
Here.
Bill Henderson?
Here.
Joe Colosimo?
Here.
Joe Verducci?
Here.
Enos Petrocelli, Senior. Virginia Schneider?
Here.
Mayor Betty Cookman?
Here.
Solicitor Tom Sherman?
Here.
Engineer Kevin Brett?
Here.
Manager Joy Collins?
Here.
Assistant Borough Manager Cheryl Moore?
Here.
Police Chief Chad King? Fire Chief Greg Hussein? Southbridge EMS Dan Miller?
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and thank you for running very, very good meetings, President. The community has been well served by your presence. Thank you for what you've done. Appreciate it. Planning Commission. One of the things the council tried to do to get the Planning Commission to be meeting was to expand it to 7. Regretfully, that does not appear to have solved the problem. I came here last month. I was aware of the fact that the Planning Commission was again not meeting. But it should meet. Even if it doesn't have a quorum, even if it doesn't have something on its agenda, it should meet. But there is no body that can deliberate the things that need to be accomplished in our community. How can we plan it? How can we do something? Again, you tried. I think that the impediment is that when there is an excuse or a reason for it not to meet, it doesn't. Perhaps in this new year, I presume it's going to be at the end of November, because it only has one more meeting left this year, right? For December.
First Monday
of December is the November and December meeting, right,
yeah.
Warren?
Yeah.
Okay. Could we make it that in the new year, the Planning Commission will meet at least once a month? And if there are no members, if there's not a quorum, that those members who are there will at least show up, that there will at least be some meeting, even if there is not a quorum, that would be very much appreciated. The other item I wanted to mention is as we come into budget, we again look at our community and our regional problems. I mentioned there is no many of us look to the completion of the bridge near Midas and Rite Aid. That is a very, very important project for our community and for the region. Unfortunately, our budget, in my opinion, does not lend itself to the expenditure of $488,000? Exactly. I am not suggesting that we eliminate everything, but I am suggesting that we reduce the amount of regional's contribution to this regional effort and look for PennDOT, Upper St. Clair, and others to come forth. This is a regional project on a regional road that benefits a region. South Fayette is putting forth their part. I understand that Bridgeville committed to do this. Okay? prior to the flood. You know, I understand that there's money that is coming in to help us from the region or from the county. At the same time, $488,000 is a lot of our tax dollars to build for regional road. Those are the two items. But thank you very much, and hope to see you with the budget here.
That's fair. Nicholas Rischalski.
Good evening. My name is Nicholas Rischalski. I live at 734 Maple Street. And thank you all for being here this evening. My twin sister and I have been in the community for 25 years. About 5 years ago, we started a fundraiser for our birthday campaign we've done and put in local businesses. This year, it's going to be a food can drive. We put boxes and say, Believe, Joy, Open Peace in several locations all throughout the community. All this food goes to the Bridgeville Area Food Bank. It will run from today until December 8th. If you're interested in donating, locate and pick up our Rail Yard Grown Taproom, Park of Soul Hair Salon, the Sun Club, Crafty Jackalope, the Alice Club on Baldwin Street, the Italian Club on Baldwin Street, Dash Dance Production, a new company on Baldwin Street, formerly Kathy's Dance Studio, Made Shows, 31, Radcop, our police station, our borough building right outside here is one block already, and at our local library. You guys can please really appreciate it. And thank you, Millie McFarlane.
On Friday, please.
It's, I'd like to congratulate Lori on recovering from courage she's demonstrated to even the human procedure is remarkable. But anyway, I have two things I wanted to talk about tonight. I called our assistant manager today to see if there was a regulation that I think I talked to the council about, or maybe it was the planning committee or the parking authority, I don't remember. But I was trying to find out if there is a regulation in the community that anybody that builds a building in the central business district doesn't have to provide parking for the business district, which there's a situation here that I'm really nervous about. That's obviously, this is the corner of Washington Avenue and Station Street. This is the section of the railroad that was purchased by the owners of this company. And this is the Dreon property. By the way, this drawing was made by, I guess, Borough Council or the parking authority, showing a 50-car parking lot in that area. Getting back to the borough statute, I just don't
understand. Borough Council did that drawing. I don't know what that
means. Well, I'm going
to... Parking.
Yeah, it was parking.
Okay.
The other name is...
Clarification.
Yeah, I just that. That's right. The thing that I'm concerned about is the regulation. I think it's in Chapter 4. You're probably familiar with, I'm not sure many other people are. It essentially says if the party that buys this piece of land wants to put a building on it, if it's within 600 feet of any other public parking space, they're allowed to build there and not provide one parking space. The distance between this piece of land and the parking lot next to the former PNC Bank is less than 600, and I'm almost certain the distance between this corner of the property and the parking lot is less than 600. I think the regulation states that it would be up to the Borough Council to grant a variance or a non-compliance, in other words, to decide whether you should make the property owner build the parking necessary for the size of the floor space in the building or not. I think that's a very, let me tell you what the outcome could be. Someone could build a building there, and I've been told that that's the intention of the property owner. Okay? It doesn't have to have a retail store. It can be entirely for 40 business executives that require 40 parking spaces. They would purchase 40 parking spaces from either this parking lot or a combination of both, which means the available empty parking spaces that are there for the businesses that are surrounding both of those parking lots be greatly diminished.
You said you heard that someone wants to put a building there?
Yes.
This is the first I've heard of that.
It was an accountant who told me, and I guess they're connected in some way. I really don't know.
Can I say something as you move forward? We have been in contact with the property owners of the building on the corner. Many times regarding that lot. They leased it for years.
Yes.
And now they purchased it.
About 5 months ago.
Yeah. And their intent always was to accommodate their building with more parking. And they had met with us regarding criteria to put in the lot. So just so you know, that's what we know about that. So as far as I know, there's no intention to build a building.
Well, that's good news, but I was going to say, if you do make any sort of arrangement with the property owner to use that area as, to build a parking lot like this for themselves and maybe their neighbors, you should make sure that it involves a contract that can never be changed, because a great introduction would be to attract, convince you guys to let them use the property for a parking lot, and then 3 years later, turn it into a building that would screw up a whole central business district. I just want to mention what you already know. This is the last vacant piece of real estate in the central business district. And I think borough officials, whether it's the parking authority or borough council or together, we should purchase them in that property. And I just wanted to, I think that's the way this property could be turned into a parking in the back of these buildings could be turned into retail stores. It would be a very important economic community. The other thing I wanted to mention to you was, and I guess this is, my thing is to expand, to make the virtual business district accessible to traffic, to consumer motors, and have enough parking so that we can be competitive with the business districts on each side of the community. We don't have to be as big to make a great deal of money for the borough. And the other part of a plan, this is the Baldwin Street area. Again, this is Fire Road, and this is Baldwin Street. And this is just one of the proposals. I think the young lady that you guys hired to solve the problem wanted to transfer this whole area into a water retention plan. And part of her program was to make Baldwin Street the main street. And this proposal simply does more than that. It makes, it leaves Bower to Road where it is, and allows Bower to Road to come 2 lanes going west. By making the difference in elevation, by the way, from Bower to Road to Baldwin Street is only 8 feet. And you compare that with the 30-foot differences between Station Street, Washington, and some of the other steep slopes that consumers have to, or pedestrians have to walk around, that would be nothing. But at any rate, by doing this, and I think Rory and you guys have been working on trying to purchase some of the land, the concept I'm trying to convey here is the area between Baldwin Street and Barter Road, and Baldwin Street and Crick should be turned into a 300 or 400 car parking lot. You'd be able to revive the Bridgeville Business District. And the Baldwin Street Business District, let's say the Baldwin Street Business District, and that business district is fundamentally better than the Washington Avenue Business District. Better topography, better access. And the other thing I wanted to mention that's important. I've mentioned this a couple times. I think the borough could increase the hundreds of thousands and maybe millions of dollars that we could have donated for us. The improvements we're suggesting are good for the entire area, not just Bridgeville. The traffic congestion solution, and this would be part of it. You have McLaughlin Run, Cookstall Road, and Bower Hill Road all coming together here. You would reduce the traffic congestion by 50% by putting something like this in and connecting it with Washington Avenue. And in general, the traffic congestion problem on Washington Avenue, make it so it's good for Collier and Southfayette, and I think you can attract some major federal agencies and state agencies that give you more money than they make.
Thank you. John Duncan.
John Duncan, Warren. I was wondering, do they move developments and the grant money for the hillside repair and things like that? It's my street in particular, it's been worse and worse all the time, Warren, on the track.
I don't have any official news on grants being awarded yet. We're supposed to make some sort of announcement tomorrow, but I'm not sure. I don't know which grants are being awarded. Is one of the grants to be applied for?
The GGU.
So I got to check. So you can ask for
another thing I wondered if anybody knew about along my street and down the side alley, they were tagging property tags with the pink tags all the way up. I don't know if they're surveying for
pink natural gas.
I think it's just a survey. I didn't know if it was for the construction that's going to be happening or if anybody knew anything.
We got a call about that today. Okay. And we haven't gotten any notification of it's not up.
Right.
And we don't have any projects pending up in that area right now. I know PennDOT's they're moving forward with the Charger Street widening and those types of things.
Okay, very
but we weren't
aware of that. Okay. One more thing. Is there any plans to make a recyclable limitation draw up for glass?
The Sun Bay Resource Council, we talked to them. Right after they stopped recycling glass.
Right.
And they set up certain areas that you can drop off at certain times of the year. There was one in South Fayette, and I think there was one in Upper St. Clair, and I asked them if Ridgeville could be a drop-off point, and they said no because, they have them in our areas. So as we get notification of them holding down, we'll put them on our Facebook page.
I was just there at Mount Lebanon 3 weeks ago, and they told me, the woman told me, that they are looking to increase the spot. And I said, well, I live in Ridgeville. And she goes, oh, that would be great. So
yeah.
I don't know whether or not she was just talking about the top of her head or.
It would be certain for us to call again because that was in the spring that I requested that. So we'll call them again.
Okay.
It makes it easier for the residents, that's for sure.
Okay. All right. That's the plan.
Thanks, Sean. Courtney Palmer, please.
Hi, good evening. Just a follow-up from last month's presentation about the proposed tree planting project on Washington Avenue. Just to let folks know, I do have the PowerPoint presentation and notes from Kenzie Miller, who was the woman from Tree Pittsburgh. So if anyone would like the original presentation, I do have that for folks. So one of the main concerns from last month in the presentation was whether or not the tree beds that are currently there would be large enough for planting of what we proposed to do. So the original planting were a honey locust tree, which has a very aggressive root system, and was planted in a 2-foot by 2-foot bed. There were aerial photos online that were taken, so comparing what the current planting situation is, current planting beds are 3 feet by 10 feet. So basically, sidewalk lifting can occur because there originally was not enough room for the trees to grow. There could have been poor construction quality of the sidewalks, but those have since been replaced. Soil moisture, there's lots of things. So multiple factors, not just what type of tree, but if there is plenty of room.
for instance, if you took 18 inches of soil volume for the original plantings with the 2x2, that would only give 6 cubic feet of soil volume, but with the current planting, that will allow for 45 cubic feet. So there's a huge difference in the amount of area for growth for the proposed planting. So there are 28 potential sites on Washington Avenue, and what we would propose is in December or January have the three Pittsburgh professionals come out and take a look at each of those specific sites. They're going to do a visual inspection to see if there are electric boxes, water lines, gas lines, gas meters, anything that may impede the healthy growth of these trees. If there is a problem with any of the planting sites, we just won't plant there. What we can do is have a plan B in place and take the trees that they are proposing for this planting and plant them somewhere else that meets good growth potential in Bridgeville. So if there's another area that you would like a tree planted and you have those trees available, we can certainly do that. But what the process would be, a preliminary look at the site to make sure that there's no wires overhead, that it's wide enough to be planted and still have pedestrian access. So that would be up to you as to whether or not you want to move forward with the preliminary search this site. That would be December or January. And then in January / February, depending on ground conditions, Tree Pittsburgh would then select a species of tree depending on each specific site. So say there's a planting bed that's right near an intersection with a lot of traffic, there's lights, you want to make sure that tree grows straight and not hanging over where you're going to have to do a lot of maintenance for making sure that the traffic lights are still visible and so it's a successful planting. So that's why they had a variety of species proposed for this project. Again, the trees need to be salt tolerant, they need to be drought tolerant, and have less reservoir habits than the previous trees. So the Tree Pittsburgh folks would then, based upon each specific planting site, go and pick the trees that would work for each specific hole that they would be digging. They would lay eyes on the trees, make sure they're healthy, make sure that they have a good, strong root structure, and then about a week, it would be 7 days, because PA1 probably requires 7 days prior to doing any type of planting or digging, that they need to come and do their pest dig and make sure that there's no additional problems with the digging site. If there is, then same situation. If they find that a hole is not going to be amenable and it's not going to be a healthy situation to plant something there, then we could move that tree into the Plan B group and put that somewhere else. As far as maintenance, I'm offering to be a volunteer coordinator for any of the maintenance that would take place for these trees, which would include setting up rotations for watering. During the first 2 years, a tree needs 20 gallons of water per tree per week. So if there's a drought situation, Tree Pittsburgh notifies you when you need to get out and do watering and things like that. So maintenance would be part of the package. So one of the other suggestions was using planter boxes in lieu of digging into the ground. So when I brought that up to Tree Pittsburgh, Tree Pittsburgh respectfully declined and said that it is not healthy to plant a tree in a box, and you're basically going to wait until the tree dies. So if we decide, if you decide, that you want to move forward by using planting boxes, the Tree Pittsburgh would respectfully remove their offer to put these trees forward to be planted. Just not something that the organization does or would ever do. As far as the cost of the trees, it's
$250 per tree. So for the 28 trees, it would be $7,000, of which Tree Pittsburgh will provide the tree, the equipment, the stake, all of the protection for the roof of the tree, and all that we would need to provide would be mulch, which we could get volunteers to either, you know, get donations or what have you to cover the nominal cost of the mulch. I would coordinate the labor for the day of planting, and I'm also going to be attending, Tree Pittsburgh has a tree tenders course for $40, which I plan on attending, and it's December 7th. And basically it teaches you how to prune a tree, where the best places to plant a tree, all kinds of crazy tree facts. So that way there's someone that knows how to do these types of things. In addition, Tree Pittsburgh will come to the site and do your first pruning, which does not need to happen until after 2 years of the tree being in the ground. And basically, we would just schedule weeding parties and workshops for the summer, and Tree Pittsburgh helps in coordination of that as well, because they want their project to succeed. And I think that's about it. Are there any questions I could answer, or?
I think there's a concern about the cost. That's a big concern, right?
Well, when we originally did the streetscape project and did the design for it, trees were included in the design. And then ultimately, after meetings and talking to business owners, the trees were taken out of the design. We have fiber optics in some of the sidewalks up there, and right now the planting area in those blocks is not very deep at all. It's probably
100%.
Yes, I do believe so, because what they did was, I think they jackhammered most of the cement, and then they left, and they brought in topsoil for just the planter boxes, but they're not deep. So they're not constructed to hold trees just because the trees were taken out of the design. So
can we leave that to a tree professional to look at each specific spot and say, this tree could be planted here, or is that?
Well, absolutely. Yeah, we can always do that. I mean, the a landscape design did come out and look at what was possible and what wasn't possible. So, you know, never say no to anything, but the concern is that with the design up there now, is it going to be able to hold the trees? We were 29 years later before we had the sidewalk problem up there. And just to make sure that if there were trees put in there, that number one, it wouldn't hurt that the sidewalk project, because we're hopeful that it's going to stay there for many years.
Sure.
And so that's just my greatest concern, that I don't, you know, and fiber optics and things underneath the sidewalk that are close,
When I did speak with Cindy, and I think she mentioned that at the last meeting, the types of trees that she has proposed for this project, if they encounter any type of resistance as they're growing, they will just divert their growth. And so I believe it's 18 inches is what is needed for a good planting base for the tree to grow. But this is just a project that we would like to work with council on. So I think if we could move forward with basically agreeing to doing the test dig for this project and see if it's not just about the day of and digging, it's a lot of volunteer coordination, it's working with public safety to make sure that the day that the trees are planted, so it's more than just, well, can't we wait a couple months and then decide then? So try trying to get the wheels in motion, and also Tree Pittsburgh, letting them know whether or not this is a viable project, which they believe it is. If it's not, then that grant money that they're willing to put forth for these trees, we'll need to cut them loose. So I would like to see if we could move forward at this point.
You're just basically looking for us to be able to define what's only coming out to see what out of those 28 spots.
We're offering
if, 28 if we'll trees. Can put something in.
Yes, and if they're not, if say there's only 10 spots up on Washington Avenue that you could put a tree, then you have 10 trees and, you know, all the trimming for those trees. If you'd like, you've got the other trees and you can plant them somewhere else. We could work with council based upon what we find and say, okay, there's another area in town that really needs some trees.
And it was like, we have a lot of trees out in charge.
So, yeah, so absolutely. Or, you know, over by the caboose. Or, you know, so just, it's a fluid project, but the proposed, the initial proposed 28 spots, and it's 28 because when Tree Pittsburgh came, that's where the planting beds currently exist. So it wouldn't cost any money, and it wouldn't cost cutting into concrete and doing site prep, which would add to the labor cost and things like that. So just wanting to see if we can move forward with it.
If council does decide to offer it in more detail,
mm-hmm.
Is there drawings or anything for the street case that we did so we can take it out?
I'm sure we'll do it in
Lori, did you say there was some problem with the business owners that caused the trees to be taken out of the design?
There were a few business owners that the previous trees had blocked their facade.
Right.
So, you know, not all, but some were preferential to not having the trees replanted because of that. So.
And certainly, I mean, we want to do this to help Rochelle, so if there's input or there's people that just there's a business that's been there for 30 years and they don't want a tree, then we can move the tree. It's just an idea.
Well, I don't know who should take precedence, but if there's someone out there who complained last time and they're still out there, maybe we could get ahead of them. Because you'd hate for them to come out cutting the tree down 3 years later or whatever comes up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
You're looking for council approval.
I have a neighbor that, if you go down in my driveway, there's 10 and that Jackie has some time, like, break in. Like, as long as the table is put 10, no chance they have any time, and that's what it looks like. So, I know in St. Clair has an ordinance, only one sign in the yard, and I wouldn't care if you put a sign back there. At 10, that's what they, I'm going to be selling that house shortly, and it just looks really
I wonder why.
Which street?
No dumping, no. Somebody dumps back there. He said the first mound is my house.
Which street?
New York Street. The house, the property owner that has the signs up, lives on the same.
Is it the circle or the?
I live on the circle. I live here. His house is on Pennsylvania. And he has a strip right behind my house. That I maintain.
Yeah, I'll talk to Tom regarding, because we really just don't have anything regarding
No water is frustrating as it can be. First Amendment issues on private property, residential property owners, signs, numbers of signs, and speech, and whatnot. So be prepared for that. Much case law by irritating the signage in the neighbor's yard.
That's why I wanted the ordinance to change that.
The Constitution supersedes the ordinance. So we can't enact an unconstitutional ordinance, nor can we enforce a legal ordinance in an unconstitutional manner. That's why I wanted
to. So even if you change the ordinance, we could fight it and say.
Yeah, or we would not be empowered to enact an unconstitutional order. But we'll take a look at
that. I was looking at the Pennsylvania law. One of the guidelines is that for personal funds that one so many 22,000 square foot.
And again, there are many statutes and ordinances and regulations that are don't always comport with the Constitution.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks, Lord. We'll get that. Okay, thank you.
All right. On to the regular meeting. Motion for the council to approve the October 14, 2019 regular meeting minutes as submitted.
Yes, sir.
That was Bruce. He was through my ear. And all those in favor? All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion of the Borough Council to approve the November 2019 bill.
I'll move.
Mr. Lucci and Junior Schneider, all those in favor? All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion of the Borough Council to approve the November 15, 22, 29 and December 6, 2019 payroll.
So moved.
Jim Buffalo. And Bruce, all those in favor? All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion for a council approving the advertisement of the 2020 budget workshop meeting to be held on November 19, 2019 at 6 p.m.
All those
in favor? All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion for a council approving the advertisement of the 2020 proposed budget to be available for public inspection Monday, November 25th, 2019. Advertisement will meet and exceed the 10-day public review requirement for a borough code. Who's that, Joe?
Yep. Second.
And you know, all those in favor?
Yeah.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion regarding resolution number 2019-14, the borough council setting the week pension fund contributions to fund the shortfall evidence by an independent actuarial study that is committed by previous ordinance and the fleet collective bargaining in the original.
So moved.
Bill Henderson and Bruce Ouchie, all those in favor? All those opposed? Motion carries. Before we get to the next one, there's an insert one here. Demolition of Worth Human Garbage Way. Going next door. Quotes have been requested from four demolition companies with three responses received this morning for the demolition of the building adjacent to the municipal building at 415 Garden Way. Bids were received as follows. Contractor Shake Excavating Contractor Incorporated, asbestos removal $4,973, demolition $14,150 for a total of $19,833. Meanfield Construction Services Incorporated, asbestos removal of $4,200, demolition $1,600 for a total bid of $20,200. And Continental Construction and Demolition LLC, including a demo bid, total asbestos included for a total of $25,500. We know construction did not submit a bid. Based on these bids, we would like to propose that Shape Excavating Contractor be accepted. Bruce?
Second.
And Nina, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion before the council regarding the following real estate tax refund due to changes in the assessment as requested by the real estate tax collector. Copies of the official change orders have been attached to the request. Year 2019, Model Law 322-E-71, the amount of $204.67. To John and Svetlana, vote.
So,
Bruce?
I'll second.
And Bill Anderson, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion to accept and pay the commission due the October 2019 real estate tax collector report.
I'll move.
True. And Bruce, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion to accept the September 2019 treasurer's report.
I'll move.
And Dr. Bucci?
Second.
Nino, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion to accept the October 2019 police report.
So moved.
Bill Henderson?
Second.
And Joe Fossil, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. And motion to accept the November 2019 zoning report.
So moved.
Bill?
Yes.
And Virginia, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Community reports. Bruce? Administration?
I don't have any, just thanks for all the meeting back.
Yeah.
It is halfway back to the public.
Yeah.
As everybody can see, we're having a meeting on November 19th at 6 o'clock, budget workshop. I asked the council to please bring any thoughts and ideas. We had a committee meeting last week, and a lot of good conversations, a lot of positive conversations. A lot of different alternative things that we could do. So we'll be bringing some of those ideas and thoughts and all kinds of fun stuff for that video.
Thanks, Joe. Parks and Recreation, other Joe.
Real quickly, all the water's been shut off in the parks. Do you want to check that quick school? It's pretty accessible. Frontiers, they generally lock that off, and also the clock can run. So, also, the restroom, new restrooms down in McLaughlin is about 50 to 60% completed, and it should be done this spring. That's all I have.
Thanks, Joe. Public Works, you know.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And you did have the report, but just not light of what Public Works has done. A lot of fall, a lot of curbs because the water, we just keep on going to the properties under. So we put quite a few curbs and get to get quite a bit of the problem. Clean catch bases, and then we collect the leaf, and I'm sure everyone of you saw that, and vehicles repair and maintenance of Public Works, et cetera, et cetera. be maintaining the creek at a certain distance, to run the debris out of it, and let's hope that it can help when the bed was structured. We don't just get it done, we do what we like to do. So we do that pretty often. So something else. Oh, we have three trucks full of salt out here at the but they're ready to go. And this is all that, which.
Thank you very much. Public safety, go ahead, sir.
Working with the chief and to arrange the next year's budget, line items that we're looking to address. Budget meeting ready for that. Also, plug to the fire department. I know they've got some fundraising activity. I'm not sure if you can talk about that a little bit more, but I don't know if I'll pass that on to you. James, plug to the fire department. That's it.
All right, thanks. Madam Mayor.
I'm thankful for all of you, and I pray that you're going to have a happy holiday season with your loved ones this Thanksgiving, and we ask your prayers for those families who will be missing their loved ones this first Thanksgiving. On November 19th, I'll be speaking to Christian Mothers of St. Barbara's Church, and they are raising 800, well, last year they gave 800 pairs of white socks to Mercy Hospital, and the doctor there and the nurses distributed them to the homeless people under bridges and things like that. And this year, St. Barbara's Christian Mothers are hoping to come up with 1,000. So if you care to donate some white socks, we would very much appreciate that. And also, by ours is also having stockings that you could fill for a soldier or any armed forces person, and they would appreciate your stocking, picking up a stocking, going in and bringing it back, and they will then see that it gets to where it needs to be. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Police Chief is not here. Tom, you have a report, please.
Yeah, we did submit our report dated November 6th. I do additional items other than what's listed in the report.
Thank you very much. Chief Hussain's on here, but Mike's here.
last month we had a total of 34 calls. 11 of those calls were assistant DMS. There's one deep accident, 5 were alarms from CO to fire alarms, and a number of other different alarms from wires down to smoke. Assistant to police and just, different calls that get. Also, I'm going to point out for this weekend, we're having one of our fundraisers, Zero Dance. So, if everybody wants a night out, to hang out with Fire Hall, we have a band called Mom Up's going to be there. It starts at 6, goes until 11 o'clock. The band starts at 8, all food, and, your turn to leave. Provided your tickets, they're $20 each. That's great. Great night out. If anybody wants tickets, we have some or contact you. All the proceeds from the dinner band goes towards the family on Union Street in August that had the house fire that they lost everything. So all the proceeds from this go directly to them, help them rebuild and establish what they had. The other table we have is called Saint Lakeville Cash. It goes off Christmas Day. So Santa Claus can bring you guys an extra Christmas gift this year of $10,000. That ticket is also $20. So if you see any fire department or me or whoever fire member, we should take it.
Thanks, Mike. We're going to score for the signing, Mary.
Excuse me. Very quickly, I just wanted to mention this is Veterans Month, and therefore, you're all invited. All of you are invited the last Tuesday night of this month, which I think is the 26th. It will be at the Fire Hall in the big room there, and it's a very interesting program. The young woman who is a government worker and is writing a book about three men from Bridgeville who were taken prisoner in World War II and came back home alive and well. One is Pete Calibro from Calibro Tire. The girl herself is directly descended from an Abood, a Mr. Abood, the Syrian families. And then his cousin was taken prisoner, different plane, but the same thing. They all ended up at the same place in a Nazi prison camp. And in honor of them, she has done many, many hours of research. And she is coming from D.C. to speak to us the last Tuesday night of this month. So please, thanking the veterans who are back and who have done so much for us, please try to come and join us. Then we will wish you a very Merry Christmas because we don't meet very much. But there's one change. On Saturday, December 7th, we will again be open from 12 till 3, and we would like families, visitors, please come see what we're up to. We are outgrowing our space, I will tell you that. Thank you very much. All of you have great holidays.
Thank you, Mary. Ritual Library.
Good evening. Ben Horton, Tech Library Director. I just wanted to combine things and give you a little overview of what the library has not produced here so far. So some of the numbers I pulled to share with you, as of today, we have 4,251 registered users at the library. This year we circulated 122,794 items, that's a variety of print and digital items. We've offered 824 programs with attendance at 11,011 people. Of that, I think I mentioned last time we hired a new outreach individual that is specifically going out in the community to serve daycares and preschools. So in the last 2 months, she has visited 9 facilities and seen 1,123 kids and adults in that time. And then also this year, as far as the use of the library, we've seen 13,798 sessions. So that is people using either our physical computers in the library or coming to the library to use our wireless. And that has resulted in over 1 million minutes of internet time at the library alone. And as happy as I am to report those numbers to you, that's only half of what the library does. The more important part is the people interactions that we have. I had intended to show a quick video from our Love Your Library Month. Unfortunately, there were technical difficulties, but essentially, at the end of September, on Sunday, September 29th, we had Yard Family Sunday and Yard Game. So it was at the library, it was at the library. The board took the lead on organizing it, and we had a really nice turnout. The video is incredible. It's on our social media, and we've been before to email it out, but it was made by one of our board members and his fiance to promote the library and promote Love Your Library, which is every September, to help raise funds for the library and promote the library's mission. And I'm happy to report this year for Love Your Library, we raised over $13,000. So I just want to thank the borough for continued support and ask that you keep us in mind as your upcoming budget season approaches. And then finally, I just wanted to mention our friends in the library group every year hosts our Christmas Tree Festival. So that's coming up once again. It starts Monday, December 2nd and goes through Saturday, December 14th. During that time, on Friday, December 13th, there's an adult-only event that'll have wine tasting and chocolate tasting from 6:30 to 9 on Friday, December 13th. And then Saturday, December 14th, from 11 to 3, it's a family afternoon where there'll be Santa and music, and you can come and see all the different trees. The trees, anyone can make one, business, organization, family, individuals, and then they're on display throughout the month. December. Thank you.
Thanks, Matt. We'll hear from the parking board. Planning commission.
No, I, no, Mr. Chairman. The only thing I like is that I mean, two people, I was checking with the attorney, I said, actually, it's in a broad part of Coates, it's orbiting up there, actually, you know, that.
Well, yeah, even though it's a recommended bar, it's
like recommended by the
follow the sunshine.
Yes. So, this is a difficulty. I mean, we could come socially, yeah, but it's not no problem. It's fine. Especially, you know, I think it out of the house. So, but the only two lots they was built was I and Mr. Cimarron. All the other members, you were at a ton. Yeah, that's exactly right. They were all out of time. So that's about all I can answer you. Yes, go ahead.
But is there a better mechanism to let people know that our meetings have been canceled?
Well, because I appreciate it too, I've kept in touch with our secretary at the office. It happened at the last minute. Even if there was a better mechanism, we wouldn't have the time to send it out. So sometimes it just happens. The night before, we really thought we had a quorum when it was booked. And then only once, nope, we got under call. And you and I were the only ones who were present. We actually toss a coin, yes and no. I think that would have been different.
And you know, you ought to put a sign up front so that some of us that ride by can see that there's no planning commission meeting tonight, because at least that was
we could do some alert like that.
The sign that you have there in the lobby, just move out and try it so we can make it.
This is the longest report about an annual report, by the way.
As I indicated, I knew that there was not a planning commission meeting. This is not a complaint about notification. This is a comment, not just about this last meeting, it is a comment about a pattern and practice. Okay? That is ongoing and has been happening for more than 5 years. You tried very hard by expanding to 7 members, and yet it does not occur. Okay? So my hope, I think others' hope, is that when you toss the coin, Mr. Petrocelli, that you come up with coming down and socializing.
That's
what we're asking for. And that would be, it would not be a quorum, but you would actually be here.
Tori?
I provided my written report to you. Would you give any comments? Also, I would just like to thank council support during my trying time these past months, and the staff, Cheryl, for being invaluable.
Old business.
One thing, please. We had a great bake sale, and I have the chairman of the bake sale here. 13 full pies, the most we've ever done so far. In May, we'll aim for more. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, an old business, I hate to do this, but for the last 3 months, I would say to somebody called Panda, we know they're not going to do that this year. I haven't got any response at all. And I'm just about to call myself as a resident of this town. At least maybe we can get an answer. When? Maybe next season? Maybe 2 years from now?
For what?
I actually talked to them at the beginning of the year, and to see if Bank Street was on their program, because we had actually been doing patching and we were a bit tired of doing it. And they had told me that they knew the condition, but it was not on this year's this past year's program. So, you know, we contact them again and see. Right.
The residents, they were like, we actually
they just said they had roads that were in a lot worse condition than they
are. Sure. We say that for Bridgeville to our residents too. We know how it works.
Anybody else have any old business?
I do. I wanted to ask Kevin, we talked about Churchill's Park and the erosion of the roadway. Were we going to look at that? I didn't see it in the report.
Yeah, we did take a look at it.
We did take a look at it?
Yeah, and there was the permit was previously filed, it's expired. So it does take another permit. I think you've had some funding requests in on that. That may be one we can actually submit in December on.
Well, I wanted to mention a gentleman that I met from Upper St. Clair recently to talk about the creek bed that was worked on across the way over by B&L Craft in the Versa Park, where they had erosion and they had built that up with concrete or whatever material it is that they used. And he was a hydraulic expert. He said you should look at that because it changes the trajectory of that water, which is now the reason why he feels that we have the erosion on our side. Wasn't sure he thought that or the state was involved in that, but somebody else that I spoke to did not think they thought that that was a private job that was done by the company across the street. So I didn't know about that. I just thought I would share that information and maybe they can help take care of it.
Any other old business? New business? Motion to adjourn?
Absolutely.
Second?